A Canberra woman holidaying in Las Vegas has described how the massacre shattered her illusion of safety in the city. Speaking to 9.com.au from Las Vegas, Laura Vojinovic said she was traveling with her boyfriend and Sin City was the end of her holiday. "We spent yesterday in Fremont Street and didn't arrive back at our hotel until 9:40," Ms. Vojinovic said. Laura Vojinovic and her boyfriend were holidaying in Las Vegas during the massacre in which 59 people were shot dead supplied. "We got an Uber back and we were telling him how safe we felt in Las Vegas compared to everywhere else. We came up to our room and rang our parents to fill them in and had a shower," she recounted. "Then we were relaxing on the bed at about 10:30 p.m. and we turned the TV on to watch a little before we fell asleep. The TV was blowing up with stories of multiple active shooters on the Las Vegas Strip and we opened our curtains and just saw police cars and sirens everywhere." Ms. Vojinovic said she and her boyfriend exited their room and looked towards the lobby, but it was a virtual ghost town with no staff around, only police telling anyone who walked through where to go. "We heard them saying they were putting people downstairs in the buffet. We watched the news and watched outside for over an hour and watched hundreds of police cars driving past, ambulances going back and forth, SWAT trucks, and helicopters circling our hotel and the Mandalay Bay Hotel. Our hotel sounded alarms saying there is an active shooter, everyone don't leave your room, and that we were in lockdown. We watched the news until about 10:30 p.m. where we saw that a shooter was captured in Mandalay Bay and that police didn't think there was any other shooters." Las Vegas police tweeted a confirmation at around midnight Las Vegas time, 6 p.m. Australian Eastern Daylight Time, that one suspect was down, tweeting half an hour later they believe there were no other shooters. Ms. Vojinovic said she and her partner tried to sleep but it was nearly impossible. "Alarms and bells were going off every now and then until about 4:30 when we were released from lockdown and allowed to exit on one side but not the Mandalay Bay side. Our hotel is connected to Mandalay Bay. The strip road in front of our hotel is closed still and it's nearly 4 p.m. here." Foreign Minister Julie Bishop has confirmed, "At this point, no Australians have been killed or wounded in the mass shooting." Speaking on the Today Show, the minister said that our consulate officers in Los Angeles and Las Vegas have been given additional staff in Washington to try and account for any Aussies who might have been in the area. "At this point, no Australians have been identified among the victims, but the foreign minister urged anyone who has friends or family in the area to contact them directly and if they have problems to contact the hotline on 1-300-555-135. Ms. Bishop said that she was deeply shocked and saddened by the shooting. "The massacre death toll currently stands at 59, while more than 500 were injured. The shooter, Stephen Paddock, took his own life, however it is unclear if it was before or just after police stormed the hotel room he was hiding in." Copyright 9 Digital Pty Ltd 2017.